Welcome to biology class, children. We are discussing the unit Environmental Biology, Ecology, and the lesson is Biodiversity and its Conservation. Okay? So, according to the revised syllabus, we have to discuss biodiversity, then biodiversity conservation, hotspots, endangered species, extinction, red data book, sacred groves, biosphere reserves, national parks, wildlife sanctuaries, and Ramsar sites. Okay, so today we can discuss the concept of biodiversity, the patterns, and examples. Okay, biodiversity or biological diversity is the occurrence of different types of ecosystems, different species of organisms and their variants like biotypes, ecotypes and gene adapted to different climates and environments of different regions, including their interactions and processes. The term biodiversity was coined by Edward Wilson. Children, the vast array of species, microorganisms, algae, fungi, plants, and animals occurring on the earth, either in the terrestrial or aquatic habitat, and the ecological complexes of which they are a part or comprises biodiversity, isn't it? And diversity ranges from macromolecules to biomes. You are aware about it, isn't it? The important diversity at the level of biological organization are of three types. Which are the genetic diversity, species diversity, and ecological diversity. Now, let's check each one of them. First one, genetic diversity. What do you mean by that? A single species might show high diversity at the genetic level over its distribution range. Two examples are given. First one, Drosophila vomitoria shows genetic variation in terms of concentration and potency of a chemical present in it, that chemical reservoir. Okay. Then next one, India has more than 50,000 genetically different strains of rice and 1,000 varieties of mango. So genetic diversity is clear now. Then species diversity. Diversity at species level. For example, the Western Ghats have more amphibian species diversity than the Eastern Ghats. Then, ecological diversity. Deserts, rainforests, mangroves, coral reefs, wetlands, estuaries, and alpine meadows are types of ecological diversity. So, our environment is diverse in different means, isn't it? You observe this diagram. So, here in this pie diagram, here the number of invertebrates are represented in form of pie diagram. Here vertebrates are given, here plants are given. So, by seeing this diagram, you might think, oh, it's very simple, isn't it? But children, keep it in mind, this question was repeatedly asked in all the question papers. Okay, so you should study this diagram carefully. Let's consider the condition of invertebrates. So, among invertebrates, insects are more. It is followed by other animal groups, then mollusks, then crustaceans. So, you should study this diagram thoroughly. Okay. Then the case of vertebrates, fishes are half the number of organisms are fishes. Then followed by birds, then reptiles, then amphibians, then mammals. In the case of plants, fungi and angiosperms are equal in amount. Then algae, then mosses, then ferns and lilies, then lichens. Okay. So, the question will come to fill the gaps, filling the blanks area and to interpret the diagram. Okay, so study these three pie diagram very well, children. Then Biodiversity and its conservation are vital environmental issues of international concern as more and more people around the world begin to realize the critical importance of biodiversity for survival and well-being on this planet. According to the IUCN, the total number of plant and animal species described so far is about 1.5 million, but still many species are yet to discovered and described. Children, more than 70% of all the species recorded are animals, while rest are plants, including algae, fungi, bryophytes, gymnosperms, and angiosperms. Among animals, 70% of total are insects. The number of fungi species in the world is more than the combined total of the species of fishes, amphibians, reptiles, and mammals. Children, you have to write your interpretations like this based on that pie diagram. Okay. Then, biodiversity in India. India is one of the 12 mega biodiversity countries of the world. We have 2.4% of land area of the world. It has 8.1% of the global species biodiversity. There are about 45,000 species of plants and about 90 to 1 lakh species of animals. New species are yet to be discovered and named. Applying Robert May's global estimate, only 22% of total species have been recorded. India has probably more than 1,000 species of plants and 3 lakh species of animals to be discovered and described. Okay, so children, read these facts lot of times. Okay, you can expect question from these sentences, and questions will be like that, to interpret the data like that. Okay, so you read the textbook thoroughly. So we can meet in next class. In next class, I will explain the patterns of biodiversity. Okay, study well, children.